I feel sorry for who's going last, because I think this is like...
Okay, we are at the Cemetery Hotel in Rochdale. We've been here twice before for the LightSpeed quiz, but never with such a good-looking lineup. We've got 11 contestants from the north of England. We'll probably get to know three more of them later, and if you watch these LightSpeed quizzes on YouTube, you'll be familiar with a lot of the faces. We've got one rookie here today. It's Mike Lees over there, who's busy setting his questions. People say, how many questions should you set for this? Really, just wait till you get here, and I'll tell you with 2 minutes to go. We have got no Martin at the moment. He's out running, but we'll be with him in a minute. Each question master today is going to have 30 questions each. If you look at the scores on the screen there, you can see that there's handicaps in operation, and that basically somebody like Clive there is giving 45 points away to everybody. On the screen you can see the names of the players, sorted by surname if there's some ambiguity. We've got a score for the particular question master set, which is the tilt. At the moment that's nil all for everybody. I'll be asking the first set. We've got a total tournament score, that's the tilt, the total score, the points scored in the tournament plus the player's handicaps, or minus the player's handicaps. And then we've got a gross score, and if you look over where Michael and Mike are, you can see some trophies which we've got for today. If you want to join in LightSpeed quiz, please do so. If you haven't got to join in one in particular, please come to Pontefract in December, where we'll be having we'll be painting like 5-pointed stars on the floor and sacrificing virgin goats. Right, look at Facebook for details. We have got 30 questions coming up, gentlemen. I hope you don't mind me being... Here we go. Fingers on the buzzer, everybody. The Crazy Gang with a sobriquet given to which Clive?
Wimbledon.
Wimbledon is correct answer. Clive can see all these, look. Clive has 2 points, which puts him on 43.
In the I thought it was going to be the trip.
Running. Oh, by the way, there's no Rochdale questions today. I couldn't be bothered.
Yeah.
Running for 204 kilometres between Neville Street and Canning Dock, which waterway links Silsden, Burnley and Wigan? Elliot by a tenth of a second.
Manchester Ship Canal.
Not the Manchester Ship Canal, Laycock.
Leeds Liverpool
is correct, and Mark Laycock carrying on where he left off. You were on -3, pulling that £5 back from last week. Because I'm worth it.
Okay.
Mike.
L'Oreal.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for all these tricks.
Tricks? There's no tricks today, not after the playoffs last month, where they've really got anything. Here we go, no tricks at all. Press after 2 words if you want. Chris Difford and Rose.
Squeeze.
Squeeze is correct, and Glenn Tilbrook comprised which group? Well, the songwriting batch of which group? Where are you, Steve? There you are. You are now on 12. This is not a pop music question. Which Saxon earned the sobriquet England's Darling after leading resistance against William the Conqueror from the Isle of Ely in... That's Sam by 0.02 seconds.
Herald with the Wake
is a correct answer, Sam. Great answer. Okay, we are going to give you 2 points there. Puts you on -13. That's you as the first game of the positive figures there. We have you on.
So is that not unlucky then?
I'm going to look at somebody here. Don Cornell and Jess Glynn have got... Debs!
No.
Mike!
Green Bandit.
No! -1 for Debs. -1 for Mike. Did that -1 go on there? It did. Sam?
Route 94.
Not Route 94.
-1.
-15. John Cornell and Jess Glynn have both had UK number ones with what title?
I was going to go for
it. Yeah, I wasn't sure. It was a gamble.
Oh, come on! Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to stop that and call it and say, hold my hand. Yeah, I'm going to sing the John Cornell version. Sam can sing the Jess Glynn version. Hold my hand, hold it tight.
Next.
Next, I'm curious this. Which town, 8 miles northeast of Dover and 8 miles south of Ramsgate, is mentioned twice in the English name of the TV programme originally created in Holland called Miljonenjacht? Oh, yes, useless you are. Sam,
deal.
Yes, deal. You were there by a nap snacker and 2 points. Good for you.
That's
on February the 25th, 1983, which playwright was found dead in his suite? Matt Lacombe.
I was going to say Philip Marlowe.
Is not Philip Marlowe. You see the general?
1983.
He died in a Deptford. Yeah, probably 1993.
Steve, he's a dead playwright. Right?
You haven't done my point.
I haven't done your point?
No, I was on minus 30.
Yeah.
Not better.
Yep.
Okay, Lacombe gets minus one. On February 25th, 1983, who was found dead in his suite, who was played at the Elysee Hotel in New York at the age of 71? The medical examiner recorded he choked. Clive, I thought you might be sneaking in there.
Tennessee Williams.
Yes, I didn't need to hear. Yeah. Oh, I think I gave Clive an extra 2 points.
We had a question
there
on Monday that said what year did he die?
Just check Clive's score, he's on minus 41. Little Nope, a mid-level sound.
Parks and Recreation.
Good answer. Give him a little round of applause. Parks and Recreation is correct. Played by Amy Poehler, mid-level bureaucrat in a fictional Illinois town called Pawnee, is the lead character of which NBC sitcom?
And the Parks and Recreation questions again.
Did I ask one last week?
Yeah, you've asked quite a few Parks and Recreation questions. Yeah.
Crap, no, I haven't. I've asked one instead of that. Probably asked the same one, actually. Here we go. What line, or name, what kind of line connects points of equal underwater depth on a map? So,
I said bath.
Yes. There's a goody looking there. Look at two shows back for that one. Sam, you're on fire, mate. Minus seven to you. After what body part was Florence and the Machine's 2000... Mike.
Lungs.
Lungs is correct by 300ths of a second. Mike, you've gone to 300ths of a second, really nothing in it. Hey up, I've lost my question. There we go. Lungs. What term shared by sailors and mountaineers applies to the securing of ropes? Laycock.
Belay.
Belay is correct. He also used it on Star Trek to say things like belay that order, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Mark's on minus two, I hope. Give any year in the life of Dick Turpin. Laker.
1702.
Nope. Well, Rose.
1655.
Nope. Michael.
1760.
Nope. Sam.
1620.
Nope. Des.
1600.
Nope. Preston.
1745.
Nope.
Was it
Elliot?
I can't. 1791.
Nope.
1700.
Nope.
1770.
Leslie, nope. It was short life. 1705. To
1739.
In 1985, who became the youngest man to win the Wimbledon men's Preston by
Becker.
Yes.
Boris.
By 200ths of a second.
Wow.
Preston, where's your slot? I've not seen it yet. There it is. You're on 27. Which New York University administers the Pulitzer Prize? Oh, Clive.
Columbia.
Columbia is correct. Why did I look at you for that one? Clive, you're on minus 39.
Ooh.
I've got my start quizzing the North Shore, I think. Saint Crispin is the patron saint. Mike.
Music.
Hey, I might need backing up on this one. No, I haven't got music, but if somebody wants to back you up, they can do. So it's minus one, unless Sam's going for something else.
That's dancing, no, it's not. Hey,
I'm not going to minus you, because I finished it. Of what?
Hey, what do you mean?
It's Sam.
No.
Preston.
It's TV and entertainment.
Michael.
Sound.
Yeah.
No, I've got here shoemakers, etc.
I've got the cobblers.
Yeah, I think that's why the etc. was there. Look, come on, get some of these, will you? It's going to look bad off, though. Nobody's getting them on music. Here we go. Which American actress featured prominently in the movies Traditional Man, The Amazing Spider-Man, Mike?
Emma Stone.
Emma Stone. And, let's continue the man thing. Anybody? Birdman.
Oh, yes, he was.
Yeah. Oh, the unexpected virtue of ignorance. End of bracket. Mike, that's a great 2 points.
I think you need to minus one me as well, sorry about that.
I've minus one to you once. Have you minus one twice?
Yeah, because I jumped in on the Crispin, didn't I?
Idiot. just be honest. Next one. You'd never catch me giving stuff away like that, would you, Sam? Next one, is it?
No, you just had a few.
Emma Stone, last answer. As of the 19th of October 2015, that was a few days ago when I set the question, the combined ages of Angelina Jolie and Emma Stone are still 16 years less than that of which TV personality whom they flank at numbers 72 and 74 in FHM's 100 Sexiest List to Matt Laycock.
Lorraine Kelly?
No, minus one.
Bitch.
Michael.
Mary Berry.
Mary Berry is the correct answer. I'm giving you an extra 2 points there. Minus 23, is that right?
That's right.
Good. Yes, it's your number 73 in the FHM list. No, for judging signature technical and showstopping challenges. Number 19. Bali, Caspian and Javan, a recently extinct subspecies. Michael.
Tiger.
Who wrote "Is There Anybody There?" said the traveller as the first line to his poem "The Listeners"? Clive.
What was Delamere?
Walter Delamere is the correct answer. Clive on minus 37. The world record for which field event has stood for several years at 86.7? Sam.
Women's javelin.
Minus one. Michael.
Hammer.
Oof, you got me off the hook there as well. But I put give a Mike to, which is wrong. Michael gets two, puts you on minus 19. Mike, you're on six. I hope that's correct.
I'm on four, I think.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
no. I thought you were on six there.
I only got two right hands.
But who's next?
Two right and I got two minuses.
Okay, well that's right then. Two right and two minuses. No, you got three right and two minuses.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Okay, next question, sorry. Where is the endodontium complex? The endodontium complex, where is it? Lacon.
Brain?
No, Preston.
Heart.
Rhodes.
Teeth.
Correct.
Oh, God.
Rose number 14. By what name is the author of The Cuckoo's Calling, Robert Dunn? Michael?
J.K. Rowling.
It's correct, Sam. I thought you were going to nail that one.
It did, but it wasn't.
Nothing in it. Off we go. Six to go. Seven to go. Who established his own pottery factory? Oh my goodness, Rhodes.
Minus
one. Preston.
Oh,
not
minus one. Laycock.
Minton.
Chippy Minton, the correct answer.
Didn't get an answer out of it.
Mark, you were going to say Minton, were you?
No, I was going to say Wedgwood.
Yes, I thought.
Seriously, Wedgwood.
Here we go, next question. In which fabulously named Cumbrian town was William Wordsworth
Cockermouth.
Cockabout.
Weren't we watching?
Closing the lead on this particular set of mine with 10 points. Close behind him is Michael. Next one is this. How many new pence equivalent to half a crown? Immediate answer required. Later.
25.
Nope. Mike.
30.
Preston.
60.
No. Sam and Clive together. Would you whisper your answer to? Go on.
I said 30.
No. He said 30, he said 26. No. Michael.
12.5
is a great answer. Minus on minus 15.
What, half a crown?
Yeah,
half a crown. I would say
Newcastle.
Yeah,
maybe ask those questions.
On July the 16th, 1945, in the desert north of Almogordo, New Mexico, Laycock.
First Euclid bomb.
Yes, that's a perfectly great answer. You're on the positive figures, Mark. Well done. Name the Coventry Labour MP, Paymaster General from May 1997 to December 1998, who resigned after it was revealed that he had lent his government colleague, Clive.
Robinson.
Yeah. Robinson is such a good answer. Jeff and who was just behind him? Preston.
Yes, well done, Clive. Yeah, Jeff Robinson.
Puts you on minus 33. Two to go. Inert, for most practical purposes, which gas derives its name from the Greek for hidden? Rhodes and Preston. Please turn to the person next to you and give an answer. Right, Preston,
go on. Go on.
Steve says argon.
What?
Argon.
No, I'm afraid it doesn't. Yeah. Clive.
Krypton
is correct, and that's a great start for Clive. We've one question to go. Minus 31 for Clive. One question to go. Come on, everybody, this is it. Take her to the moon for me, okay? Is a request issued to Joy by Bing Bong. Mike.
It's
Time's up, I'm afraid.
It's awesome, isn't it?
Minus one.
Oh, no, it now.
Is a request issued to Joy by Bing Bong whilst in Riley's memory dump in what 2015 film? Sam.
Inside Out.
Is correct. Oh, my God, to the at the end of that particular round,
I thought you were on to it.
Clive! Miles in front, give us a round of applause. We'll stop the cameras, have a break, and make sure everything's
working. Thank you.